Hey guys, my name is JessiMew, and welcome back to Cattails. In the last episode, we went back into the mines to do a little bit more work for Molo the Mole, and while we still haven't found any of those super special gems, we did find one of his little miner friends, and he certainly had quite a bit more luck than we did. So we have officially seen the gems for ourselves with our very own eyes, and Penny has the scent of gemstones ingrained into her mind, so I'm sure she is itching to get back into the mines pretty soon. But today is going to be a day of replenishing our stocks, because unfortunately we ended up using basically all of our food supplies in the process. We don't even have any little berries left over anymore because Penny had to eat this morning, so I think we're going to have to try to find some more of the winter blueberries kind of hidden about the world. We did manage to find quite a few of them in the swamplands, so today I think we're going to turn our attentions to the northern portions of the map, where the mountain cats live. We actually haven't explored this area in the wintertime yet. We've only gone down to the mystic cats, so I'm hoping that means there's going to be plenty of little berry bushes for us to pick from. And I think we'll also bring our lavender too, so we can hopefully spread that on some of the furthest reaches of our territory. It looks like we even have a little skirmish taking place right at the edge, so we're going to have to poke our heads in there, but if we can, it might be a good idea to try to settle this as peacefully as possible. We're going to try to use our lavender, and if we can get enough skill points too, maybe we could even finally buy that diplomacy skill. So we can see if Penny might be able to talk her way into a world domination, I suppose. She is a very friendly cat. She's probably the friendliest little bugger I have ever known in my entire life, so hopefully that'll be enough to get the cats on her side. But can we catch this crow? Yes, excellent! There we go, Penny, so you don't have to worry about going hungry at least as you're trying to catch your food, trying to provide for all of your forest colony friends. But let's see if you can find any of those berries hidden around here, because I don't think we've been up this way in quite a while. So far it looks very, very bare, though honestly, the mines weren't too bad of a place for us to find food in general. We learned that there are quite a few different harvest mice that we can find inside the rocks themselves. Oh, and there is a mouse. Oh, I'm sure Scout would be very impressed if we could bring some mice back for him too, right in the thick of winter. Oh no, that one definitely got away from us. Okay, we were a little bit too far away. She'll have to use her study prey skill if we find something a little bit bigger. Something like a rabbit maybe that we really don't want to lose, but there's our winter berries. I had a feeling there would be quite a few up here. Yeah, I don't think we've gone collecting in the north since the winter time started, so we should be able to find lots and lots of berries. Where are we actually? Because this is a good place for us to be, the Flower Plains, and luckily that is right inside our own territory, so we should be very, very safe as we're trying to find some food for ourselves. We have the Canyon Ruins, which was one of the very first places that we won on one of our skirmish battles, so this place is under our control too, which is very good to see. We haven't had the mountain cats try to invade in quite a while, and honestly, they have always been a little bit more lenient toward us than the mystic cats. So hopefully our luck will continue today and we'll be able to tread peacefully through the north. In fact, let's use some of our lavender in the northern portions up here, the canyon plains. Let's see if this will be enough to maybe put this under our control. Oh, very, very close, but not quite close enough. Let's use our other one too then. There we go, I think that may have done it. Yeah, we actually have this entire tile under our control now, so we're getting there. We're slowly but surely reaching out toward the top and the bottom of the map. Pretty soon we might even have the beach under our control too, and then we can go scouting for shells when it warms up a little bit. It's probably very, very cold for poor little Penny to dip her toes into the ocean at this time of year. She doesn't even know how to swim very well, so we're going to have to ask Lyris if he wouldn't mind teaching us someday. Oh, that tuff got away too. Oh no, Penny. Now you're having a little bit of trouble, but I think that's probably because you're very, very hungry. So let's eat that crow that you caught earlier today, and then perhaps it would be a good idea for us to take one of our golden seals too. Luckily, we do have plenty of these inside our den as well. We shouldn't have to worry about running out of those anytime soon, which is good because we can't exactly find them out in the wintertime weather. And I think we are very close to that battle now. You're just a couple tiles away. It might even be the Mystic Cats too, which is a little bit worrying because it's so far away from their territory. I have a feeling they're very upset with us though. They must be super mad that we stole so much of their food the day before. That's probably why they're coming out in droves. Let's see if we can get rid of them though. We have quite the army here. Rose and Hunter and Fern and Moon. Oh, but they have quite the army too. It looks like it's actually the Mountain Cats, so that's good. Typically, we have much more luck when we're trying to get rid of the Mountain Cats because they seem a little less trained for war. So we have protected the entrance to the mines, which is very good for us. And in fact, the mines are completely under our control now too. Excellent. So we don't have to worry about any of those Mountain Cats sneaking in here and stealing those gemstones for themselves. You know, it is going to be very hard to convince myself to give these gemstones over to Molo instead of taking them home to put inside our den. But it looks like we don't have any little harvest mice to gather up inside the main chamber today. So we'll scoot back outside and see if we can find anything in the surrounding area. Unfortunately, now we only have berries in our inventory, so it would be nice to take back a little bit of meat. I'm sure Penny would like something a little bit more substantial for her supper, or even her breakfast when she wakes up. In fact, let's see if we can find anything in the graveyard or the shady corners that we were exploring in the previous season. Maybe they have something hidden away up there. You would just expect that something would be in those shady corners. There is a little frog on the ice too. Well, we might as well give this a shot, but we are going to have to study our prey because this is going to be very tricky. Hunting on the ice, oh my gosh, and we're slipping and everything, but we did manage to get it. Penny, the master hunter, can even catch frogs while she's slipping on the ice. Very good, you must be improving your skills. But now we're in the graveyard, so let's see if we can find any little berries to pick up, anything that might be scooting around all these tombstones. This is where we found quite a few of those damselflies in the autumn, but there's a mouse. Okay, let's try to get this one. It shouldn't be too hard if we get just a little bit closer and pounce. There we go, Penny. And another mouse too. All right, this is good to see. It seems like the mice like to hang out by the graveyard in the wintertime. So very, very spooky mice. Are you really going all the way around the tree again, little guy? Let's try to get you from behind right here. Thankfully, because there are no leaves on the trees, we don't have to worry about losing that meat. And now we have plenty of food to take back with us. In fact, we'll go ahead and munch on one of these little mice so we'll have enough energy to get back home, or enough energy to get to the shady corners even, because I do want to see if they're hiding anything up there. We actually found some of the autumn berries. Were they the blackberries, maybe? I can't quite remember which one we could find in the autumn, but we did find some of them up here, hidden away behind these trees. There we go. Some more of our lovely winter blueberries all over the place. Excellent. Do we have enough skill points now? Yeah, just enough, 103. So let's go ahead and buy this diplomacy skill. We'll unlock this, and then when we go back to our den for the night, we'll make sure we place it inside our little quick bar here. I guess we'll probably get rid of the sprinting ability since we can only have 4 activated at once. We typically use the sprinting to get away from those nasty battles, but Penny has been pretty lucky so far, and if she does get into a nasty scrap, she can always summon her allies instead. Violet, you're out very far today too. Let's see what you're up to. I've made up my mind to try to sneak away from the borders and see how far I can get before another cat finds me. It's dangerous but exciting. Oh, no wonder. She's living life to the fullest, it sounds like. Penny was actually doing something very, very similar not too long ago. That's how we found us so much food after all, stealing it from the other colonies. So you can understand why they might be a little bit angry at us, just a little bit, but she's going to have to try to talk her way out of these battles now with her diplomatic skills. Now I think we're wandering in basically the same path that we already took, so let's go a little bit further off to the right. Oh no, there was a dove on the water there. Oh, I completely missed that. But yeah, if we go off to the right, then we might be able to find something. Oh my goodness, new. Like a giant battle. Okay, well, let's get our paws into this one because they're having a little bit more trouble than our other cats were. Oh my goodness, maybe we need to summon our allies into this one because they completely took out all of our cats. There we go, Captain and Coco, we can do this, right? Let's go ahead and heal up a little bit because we are getting quite hurt. Let's use one of our golden seals and then charge back in to get Lucy. I think we're gonna do it. There we go. Oh, thank you so much, Captain and Coco. You did an absolutely wonderful job helping us out. Don't worry, the borders are safe with me. They certainly are. And Captain, hey friend, good to see you. You as well, Captain. Thank you so much for saving Little Penny's tail. This is actually right by the entrance to the mines again. So go figure, I guess those mountain cats really wanted to keep this under their control. They must want to sneak in there and grab those gemstones after all. But I think it might be time for Penny to go to bed. It's actually already after 1:30 in the morning, so we'll pick up a couple more of these winter berries and then a scoot on back home. That was actually a pretty good harvest too. That was right at the forest lake, so it sounds like we want to go to the flower plains and the forest lake when we're looking for a little bit of extra food to munch on. I'll have to try to make a mental note of that. I know the abandoned cottage actually has quite a few raspberries when the summertime rolls around. We haven't actually experienced the springtime just yet, so I'm really looking forward to seeing what we can find around the world in that season too. I believe we still have about 4 more days of the winter time to go though, so plenty of time for Penny to enjoy skating around on the ice. But let's go to sleep for now so she can sleep off some of those wounds, of course, some of those battle scars, and then we'll see if we can equip our diplomacy skill and give that a try too. World domination feels like it could finally be within reach. So let's see, can we unequip the sprint skill? Yeah, let's unequip that and place the diplomacy right in its place, right in slot number 1. So use the skill in a contested region to gain lots of power for your colony there. So I guess we're going to have to go along the edges of our territory yet again and try to spread our influence all throughout the land. Honestly, like, we're getting really close to the mountain cats' territory. We are definitely starting to encroach upon their space. It'll be interesting to see if we can take over some of these blue tiles too. I think we can because it looks like we have a tiny, tiny bit of influence right in the grove up here. But I think it might be a little bit more beneficial to us if we tried to push into the Mystic Cat territory instead, because those guys are belligerent to say the least. So if we had a little bit more safe ground to work with, we might be able to take them over too. But let's munch on a couple more berries before we leave for the day. We'll eat a couple of these so we're nice and full, and then we'll give it a shot. We'll go toward the southern portions of the map this time and see if we can possibly spread our influence a little bit more. Oh, Lyrus, you're outside of your den. I wonder how he enjoys the winter time. First they crawl, then they run. Over the white-blue ground, speeding on, they reach their goal, on distant shores that take their toll. Oh, Lyrus, that was very nice. It sounds like he's a little budding poet after all. I wrote that poem while peering across a lake to the northwest. You should visit it sometime and sit on its shores while you think. So Lyrus does enjoy spending time right by the waterside after all, which makes quite a bit of sense when you think about it. It must be a good place for him to find inspiration for all of those poems. But let's scoot on down to the south here. Maybe we'll try taking over, oh my gosh, the beach. Wait a second, this might be a little bit of a problem. We can't actually call our allies this time, so we're going to have to do this all by ourselves. I think we're doing good. We only have a couple more to go. Wow, excellent. Oh my goodness. We're down to just one poor little cat, but we actually managed to do it. Good job, little guy. A big juicy trout would be perfect right now. Well, I'm not sure if you're going to be able to find those because the lakes are a little bit frozen. The rivers and the lakes in the area, we haven't seen a single fish all winter long, and there is a pretty good reason for that. We actually haven't caught any fish either. It would be pretty nice if we could try to go fishing once the lakes start to thaw, but we will have to learn how to swim a little bit better first. We don't want to get caught in those nasty currents after all. But let's go right over to the very corner of the map, the beach west, and we'll see if maybe we could get this under our control if we use our diplomacy skills. Oh my goodness. Oh, that is so adorable. It looks like we did actually get quite a bit of power in this place. Very, very good. So we're up to 69% on the western shores of the beach. And now we can collect all these shells too. All of these little trinkets to bring back to our den and maybe surprise Lyrus with. It looks like the diplomacy skill does take quite a while to cool down, so we'll have to keep that in mind. And oh no, I scared away the that toad. So I guess we can find them toads down by the beach, that's good to know. There typically isn't too much for us to discover here aside from the shells. So we'll have to keep our eyes open after all. Maybe we can find a little mouse to snag up and bring back. Oh, there's a dove. A little dove for us to catch. Let's study our prey so we can do this right. Get a little bit closer and pounce. In fact, let's go ahead and break into that lovely dove so you'll have just enough energy to keep you going. We'll see if we can find anything away from the water. That's going to be a little bit too tricky for her to get around. But we can go right across the ice over here and maybe make our way toward the ancient ruins, or the sacred temple, rather. I don't think we explored too much around there either. For the most part, we went right to the southern portions, right into the swamp, after we made it over to the temple itself. So let's see if we can explore the hallowed ground. I don't think we've even set foot in there yet, and it seems like the mountain cats have really taken control. We don't want them to spread their territory too close to the sacred temple, because that seems like it's going to be a very special place. Maybe once we can make our own colonies, who knows? Oh, there we go. There's one tiny little berry on that bush that we can grab after we try to grab this other mouse as well. Yes, Scout is going to be quite pleased with us if we give him another little morsel to munch on. He must be working pretty hard as well. Oh, Tabitha. Oh my goodness, look at that red-eyed cat just glaring at us, just staring us down from that tree. That was very, very spooky. Okay, Tabitha, let's get rid of you. Luckily, she didn't hit us very hard, so maybe she was a little bit wary of us. It seems like she didn't actually want to fight us too much, but Admiral is charging in after her. Oh, she must have been his friend, and he's trying to avenge her. Well, let's get on out of here before we run into any more trouble, because I guess the Mystic Cats are very close to their borders today. They're keeping a close eye on us after everything we stole from them the day before. So let's see what the Hollowed Garden is like. The Hollowed Garden, oh, this place must be beautiful in the spring. When all of these leaves are on the trees, we are definitely going to have to take a little field trip back here once the trees start to grow again. Once there's life all around the forest, I bet this would be a wonderful place to spend our days. There's even little lanterns lighting the way for us. Maybe we could go firefly hunting in the summertime once they start coming out in droves again, and we can get back to work trying to finish Penny's rainbow firefly collection. Our diplomacy skill is ready again though, so since we're so close to our territory anyway, we'll go ahead and use it right here. Yeah, look at that. Penny's doing an excellent job gaining influence. So it's not all about fighting all the time. It does certainly help to sharpen your claws every now and then when it comes to these skirmish battles on the borders. But we can use our words just as well, and all of that lovely lavender too. We'll have to make sure that we gather up a little bit more of that once the springtime rolls around again and everything starts to grow. But Penny has done a wonderful job filling her pockets too. Filling them to bursting with all sorts of little morsels for her to snack on. Frogs and mice and even a little bunny as well. So maybe tomorrow we'll go ahead and give one to Scout. I'm sure he would really like one of those mice to enjoy for his breakfast. We have these berries, of course, to maybe offer to Missy. Maybe, if she's not going to be super cranky about it anyway. But since we were so successful today, let's go ahead and take a quick peek at our skills too before we end out the episode, because it looks like we have just enough to upgrade our hunting again. So why don't we go ahead and give Penny a little bit of a boost in her hunting skills? Since we've already bought another active skill today, I'm sure the hunting would be very beneficial as we're ending out the winter time. So at level 4 in hunting, it should be just a tiny bit easier for her to pounce on all of that prey, and hopefully that means our den will be thriving again pretty soon, with lots and lots of food for her to eat all throughout the seasons. But for now, thank you all so much for watching, and I'll see you all next time. Bye guys!